Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Thanks for coming and joining us this morning. This morning is going to be just a fantastic opportunity for you to see your son and daughter perform something that they wrote. And throughout the last five, and this was a five-day process, by the way, working with Randy Peters, and I've got to tell you, the work that these kids have done, all of them, to write the lyrics of a song, and for Randy Peters to put these words to music is absolutely unbelievable. Randy Peterson was last with us in 2005, so we were just so excited to have the opportunity to have him join us. And we're very fortunate that our PTO is sponsoring this resident in artist experience for our kids. So the songs that we selected, or we chose to write about, were about the Seven Habits. And you may have heard about the Seven Habits. Our Sunnyside t-shirts are about the Seven Habits, talking about making good choices, talking about working together, talking about thinking win-win, talking about being responsible, respectful, you name it, you're gonna hear it today. And again, we are so blessed to have Randy work with our kids. So I'm going to introduce Randy Peterson, and he will say a few words, and we hope you enjoy the show. Mr. Randy Peterson, you're right here in your room. Thank you. Hi, everybody. Thanks again to those of you who came early and helped me with all that sound checking. Thanks. Had a great week here at Sunnyside last week. The program you're going to hear today, the music, every word of every song you're going to hear, did not exist before last Monday morning. So we're all created last week here at Sunnyside. And before the first song is sung, I'd like to just briefly tell you about how we did it. The one thing before I got here, I asked, is that they think ahead to what topic they would like to do. So that was decided. Each group knew what theirs was going to be. So the first thing I did with them is we discussed it. What does it mean? Have them tell me what the seven habits, whether it's responsibility, being respectful, responsible, and safe, what does that mean? We discussed what the song had to say. We decided what were the important points we wanted to have brought across in our song. And then I took my guitar and strummed one style, strummed a different style, and we decided on what our song wanted to sound like by raises of hands and folds. And then we made a musical map of the song just by singing la 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 la. So we could sing it. Didn't have words yet, but we could sing the song just by going la 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 and na 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 up here and there. And then once we had the melody figured out, then we started writing words to fit the la la las. And so we wrote one sentence, two sentences, we made a rhyme, we looked at what we had, we sang the two sentences, we decided what should come next, and over the first hour, we built pretty much the entire song. Most groups got it done in that first session. A couple songs were a little longer, and they took the second session part of that too. But basically, what I'm trying to say is these songs were created very fast and written very well by your students. The ideas, the words come from your kids, and the rest of the week we practice them. I'm going to fill you in a little more on the rest of the details as we switch groups and things. But without further ado, could I please have the fourth graders from Ms. Duran's class and Mrs. Fullerton's class to stand up. And they're going to sing the first song today in today's program. It is called Respectful, Responsible, and Safe. Thank you. Way to start the show. Now, we didn't get to do a true John sound check. Would you hear the kids okay?
Yes.
Okay. Guitar wasn't too loud? I won't be hurt if it was. You can tell me. Awesome, kids. Way to go. You're going to notice as we sing that we're not using any lyrics today. And that's really quite amazing for a song that was just written last week. Sometimes you'll hear me give little cue words of what's coming, and usually I find that they really don't need it. But I sometimes feel better, like, okay, what if they don't know those first couple words of this next sentence? But you know what? It's mostly my memory that I find failing. The way we did it was after we wrote, let's say we got the three quarters of the song done that first day, what we did was recorded it on a small recorder, just a little handheld digital recorder. We recorded the words we had and the song as it was, and I put it on the classroom computers so they could listen to it in their classroom. And so from time to time during their day, during the week, they were able to have the lyrics reinforced by listening to it in the classroom. So teachers out there, all the classrooms, thank you all for doing that last week. It made this concert possible. Well, the rest of the kids, we have two groups coming in this one. First of all, I would like to ask all the first graders to please sit down. And those who are left standing are the fifth graders from Mrs. Staples' class, and their song is called PBIS Behavior Model, and it is called PBIS Sets the Bar.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Understood. It's one of the seven habits. Basically, it's don't speak your mind until you understand what the other person is trying to say. The song will tell you all. Are you ready? That song, awesome. Awesome job. Well done. Mr. Ace and Mr. Camden, fifth grade classes. Very, very good. All right. Do you know how you need to go off? You can do it now, probably. during my week here at Sunnyside last week. I met with the kids three times. The first day was the composing day, where we made all of our decisions about words and the sound of the music. The second day, we had our song written, and on that day, we rehearsed, and we sang it a whole bunch of times, and just found the best key for their voices, and we just fine-tuned the songs, and prepared for the third day, which was a recording day, where we recorded all of these songs in a small recording studio I brought into the music room. And all of those songs are going to be on a CD. I know it's going to be coming home this week, called Get One. What I'm going to do with the song after it's, now that I have the kids' voices recorded, is I go back to my home studio, and I'm going to be putting background music, drums, electric guitar, bass guitar, mandolin, banjo, whatever the song might need. And I've been showing the kids how this is going to happen during our sessions last week. But it's going to sound like a band is playing with them. It'll all be me, but it'll be the sound of a band accompanying these songs. Something a group on this stage. Alright everybody, what we're going to do is we're going to have the first graders keep standing, and then I'd like Mrs. School's class and the 4K kids to please sit down, okay? Alright, let me move these microphones. By the way, I didn't mention your teacher's name. This is Mrs. Robertson's class. Raise your hand if you're from Mrs. Robertson's class. They're behind me right here. And that means the rest of you must be Ms. Bedora's students. Is that right? Raise your hands. There they are. Their song is called Work First and Play Later. Kindergarten and 4K from Ms. Potts' class and Mrs. School's class. Mrs. Potts' class, would you raise your hands? There they are. Mrs. School's class, raise yours. There they are. Right. Their song is called Be Proactive. One more big round of applause.
Thank you.
Okay, everybody who's joined us on stage, we have second graders and third graders. We're going to have the third graders sit down first for this first one, all the second graders say. And here we have the second graders from Mrs. King's class. And the song we're going to be doing today was mostly written during the great power outage of 2014. They were in the dark, or else lights were going on and off for most of this writing of this one. So it was a big, I thought a big accomplishment to finish it during all that going on. The song is called Begin With The End In Mind. This is Mrs. King's second grade class.
Thank you.
third graders for Mr. Julie's class, and from Mrs. Calloway's class, wrote a song also about being proactive. It has a whole different style and kind of a different take on it. This is called Always Being Proactive. I've been so looking forward to coming back to Sunnyside. Every time I've been here, it has been a wonderful experience. I was here a number of times through the years, but the main one that I remember going back is back in 2005 when we did this. We did a concert, I think, at the Wyatt that year. Yeah, that was awesome. But you know what? There's something very special about being in your own place right here at school. And to be able to have this broadcast to all of our classrooms is really a neat way to do this show. But every time I've been here, when I started to sing, it's been a great experience, not just because of the kids, because of you all coming to the shows, but because of the teachers. Mrs. Nimmer has just been such an awesome teacher to work with. She prepares her kids so well. She has such a good way of teaching singing, teaching music, and that helps my job so much when I come in and the kids are able to sing this well. So, and also Mrs. Nimmer has helped. How long has Ms. Ballinger been here? A couple of weeks?
2 weeks.
2 weeks? have a student teacher that's been helping out. She was a wonderful help all week as well, singing and helping us all to get our songs sounding as good as they could. So, Ms. Bellinger, Mrs. Nimmer, were just an amazing help. Plus, I commandeered their rooms for the week. Berzowski's class, kindergartners. Everybody, kindergartners, raise your hand and wave to everybody. I think a lot of you, some of you know here. Their song is called Always Make a Plan. A few minutes ago, you heard a song about make a plan, thinking ahead. This is another song about that topic, but it's very, very different. This one was based on a story they've all read about who the bear, and what was the other name? Jumper the Rabbit. So on your programs, it says Goop and Jumper. On my sheet music here, it says Always Make a Plan. So we have to decide on what the title is. But it's about Goop and Jumper always making a plan. So maybe that's the title. Kindergartners, way to sing. You can sit down now, please. Get her on the half. The second graders, please, from Mrs. I'm going to get the name right, Mrs. Stern Johnson, and also Mrs. Wordle's class. Their song is called Think Win Win.
Thank you.
Tomlin's class, raise your hand. There they are. That must mean the rest of you should raise your hand next, because you're in Mrs. Moore's class. They've written a song called Synergize. This is about working together. Working together gets it done much better than trying to everybody just do their own thing. It's called Synergize. Miss Potts' class of 4K students wrote a song about friendship, and this song incorporates a lot of the ideas that a lot of the other songs have. It's called We Like Being Friends.
You're a friend of mine.
You're a friend of mine.
sing and play. I could play guitar with you singing that all day. You sing it back up. You sound really, really good. Thank you so much. We're going to let you go. And the next one's ready to come in. There they are. All right. First row. While they're headed up, give them one more round of applause. Celebrating their school. These are the fourth graders with their song called Sunnyside. Thank you for interrupting your schedule for the week to make this possible, practicing the songs with the kids when I wasn't able to be there. Thank you all the entire staff of teachers for all your help this week. The staff also, I want to include the office and the custodial staffs that helped me get in, get out, get things I needed. Mr. Olson, there you are, Mr. Olson. Thank you so much for making me so welcome and for having me back to your wonderful school here. Mrs. Nimmer, I already thanked you, but you deserve to be thanked again for your great work you do with these kids and the good job you do setting this up for me. Thank you, and Ms. Bellinger too. The Sunnyside PTO, if there are any members here, thank you so much. Without the PTO, I wouldn't be here. They funded this whole week. So thank you to the PTO. And be sure to thank them for me, okay? That's all I have down. The biggest thanks I want to say is thank you to all the kids, all of you kids in the classroom, on stage, who did all the writing that went into these songs and all the hard work and singing. It's really been fun. Let's finish this song once again. Let's back up and reintroduce the fourth graders with their song called Sunnyside.
Yeah.
chorus one more time, and please sing with us wherever you are in school. Ready? One. Thanks for coming, and if you want to see it again, it'll be streamed live, so thanks everyone.